I don't know if I've ever said it on this channel before, but I am a fan of the Millennium series, the Girl with a Dragon Tattoo series, the books, the Swedish films, and the American film. And if you all are fans of it, or some of you, or whoever is watching this video, if you have knowledge of it, well, the American film came out in 2011, and there's supposed to be, you know, two sequels, and this was before the fourth book came out, which was written based off of the plans from the author, who was in the process of doing an outline, and he planned it for like 10 books in the series, but was finishing the third film or book, and then he died of a heart attack, I believe, if I'm remembering right. Anyway, well, they're finally doing another girl movie, but instead of it being... I'm sorry, I was looking up for the books that I have up there. Girl Who Played With Fire, yeah, just to refresh my memory, which was the sequel to The Girl with a Dragon Tattoo, you know, and followed by The Girl Who Kicked the Hornet's Nest. What they're gonna do is reboot the entire franchise with the fourth book. Because the world doesn't have enough reboots. My thought is, why do that? Yeah. Also, how do you know the fourth book would even be a success? Like, when they announced that the fourth book was... I believe it just came out. And I believe it got paused. I haven't read the book. I have it, but other things have happened. I just never gotten a chance to ever read it. I have a lot of books like that I've never read. I've just bought just to make me look smart. That's my thought. Like, yep, I read a lot, clearly, because I have books. Now, that series I really enjoy, but I don't know. I just never have read the fourth, and it's not that I don't have an interest. I mean, I bought the book. Again, I never really read the Harry Potter books. That's because also people kept ruining them for me. Every time I would try to read in school, people would talk about them. And I would try not to pay attention and hear what they were saying, but sometimes that's completely impossible, particularly when the people are sitting right next to you and they talk loudly. So you trying to completely shut them out is basically impossible. And they talk about all these important plot points that happen in the book, which you haven't read yet, because they're talking about, because they don't care if anyone around them is interested at all. And they're just too busy talking about it. And these were various other people as each year of the books went by. Too. It's not just the same people. Some of those people I did go to high school with all the way through. But still. Anyway, I just haven't read the fourth book. My thought was, it basically just came out and you're deciding to reboot it instead of doing two films. Because you need... Depending on how the fourth book is, and I've just had heard vague descriptions, like take place years after the third one, and things happen, so the main characters, Mikael Blomqvist and Elizabeth Slander, have to get back together and solve another mystery, basically. I guess sort of reminiscent of the first book, in a way, in that... If you've read the first book or know about it, or seen the movies, a bit, basically, if you've seen the original Swedish trilogy and you've read the books, and the way the setup of the American version was, because of how it has like a cliffhanger, spoiler, there is a cliffhanger, but I'm not going to say what it is in case you have never seen the movie. But it's like, alright, in the next few years, they're going to do a sequel. And then the next one, because I remember reading years ago about what they were going to do, is see how well the first one did, and then right after that, write the next two movies. That way they have the scripts completed, and then they will film for 2 years, and then back to back, another 2 years, we will get to see them. So it's like December of, I think what they wanted was like a 2000. Oh, it came out in 2011, the American one, and then the next two they were aiming for 2015 and 16. So basically by now they're completely done and over with, but then with the fourth book, who knows. Basically my thought is, I like that plan, but things happened, and they kept delaying it over and over again, despite the fact that for a while, the scripts were actually complete. And basically what they were doing is they were waiting for the director, David Fincher, and the actors and actresses, particularly the main ones, Daniel Craig and Rooney Mara, to be available for being able to set aside their schedule or clear it out or just be free for like 2 years. And then there you go. Now, Rooney Mara was signed up for 3 films when she did the first one. She did one, so basically her contract says 2 more. And the further this has gone on, the longer like this is prolonged. They keep asking her every so often. Basically, whenever there's a new movie, they keep asking her about, when's the next girl movie coming out? Like, when's girl played with fire, your old kick the hornet's nest. When's that happening? And she's like, for a long time, she had no idea. She signed up for them. That's all she knows. And she likes the character. She really likes the character. She said it's a great character to play. And I like that character, too. I would have to say that's my favorite. Elizabeth Salander is my favorite, my favorite fictional female character ever, really. I just liked her. She's, I don't know. I just like her. She's very smart. She really doesn't take shit from anyone, really. There's just a lot about the character that, if I started to go into, this video would be really long, and, you know, I've done long videos before, and I don't want to make this any longer than it needs to be, so I'm not going to get into that, but basically, you know, just giving some backstory about this, and basically what's going on is she, you know, she's enthused. She likes the character and wants to come back. Great. The director, though, never signed a contract to do anymore. Daniel Craig never did. But then again, you know, he signed on to be James Bond 5 times. And looks like he will never fulfill the 5-movie contract. Because he's basically saying, I'm done with James Bond. Because he thought for between Skyfall and Spectre, like, you need like another year at least before he felt like appropriate to do it. And also, I guess he wasn't completely happy with Spectre. I like Spectre, personally. I thought it was a it was a good movie, and the way it ends is, you know, if it's the last Daniel Craig film, I'll just say it's a good send-off for him and his Bond. If you haven't seen it, I'll just leave it at that. So that was another thing, you know. I think that the studio was really waiting for Craig to be either done with his Bond contract or be available enough between the Bond films to be able to do the sequels. Because, again, you know, their idea was to film it back-to-back. And, you know, their contract, or it was only for Rooney Mara, and so they could go on without him. But, and there's also word, aside from Bond, that, you know, he was wanting too much money. Now, no official representative of Daniel Craig, nor Daniel Craig himself, has ever said this. It's just stuff from the studio or whatever, but maybe it's because, you know, it was taking so long for them to getting the sequels made. It just, for whatever reason, like, maybe they thought that, or somebody said something about that, maybe, whether it was true or not. But they kind of went with that, and who knows, maybe it was true, maybe it wasn't. But also, I believe what happened was, because, you know, it's Columbia and Sony, I think a few factors happened. Sony, Columbia, all that, you know, they released the film. The film itself wasn't a big box office hit. It made its money back, but just a little more. Like, they wanted it to be a blockbuster, and it wasn't. But then again, they put it out in December, so I'm like, you know, not many franchises, unless, you know, it's Star Wars now, but, you know, it's a franchise, a specific franchise, like a comic book film or Star Wars. You might not get your money back a lot, because, you know, and also it's not necessarily the kind of film you might expect to be a big, huge blockbuster either. I'm not saying that the Millennium Trilogy, Millennium Series, because that's what it is called, Millennium Series, it's not that it could never be a blockbuster franchise. It's just, it's really a mystery, thriller, drama series, and, you know, and those are great, but those aren't necessarily the kind of films that you would think of when you hear the term blockbuster, usually, at least not nowadays. Maybe years ago, perhaps, if you had the right story and you just had the right ingredients. But, you know, it didn't make as much money as they hoped. So that could have prolonged a sequel. Stupid, but okay, there's that. Another thing is because, you know, Sony, everybody knows about the Sony hack that happened. Well, you know, for like 2014, somewhere around there. Basically, I believe that had a impact on how they were going to proceed with the future of anything after The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. Yeah, I believe it was 14, because some early scripts of Spectre came out. That was like the big thing people talked about. Not at all the Dragon Tattoo sequel scripts, because those were, if I recall correctly, they were finished. They were actually finished, because I believe earlier in that year, or late 2013, the writer was basically done with either both of them, or was almost done with the second one, the third film. Just almost done. The first sequel's done, written. The third, last one's almost done, if he wasn't already done. So basically by that time that came out, happened, the scripts were done, completed, sitting there waiting for cast and director, actors being available for 2 years to shoot. And that happened. That probably changed how they were going to approach it, obviously. I also kind of think that's a bit dumb, but that's just me. Because word was, after a while, as I kind of said earlier, they're going to reboot it with the fourth book. Now, how do we know if the fourth book was well-liked? What if people didn't really like the fourth book? I mean, yeah, it would sell millions because it's part of that franchise, that series. Yet, aside from that, what if people, the public, were very vocal about not liking it? And I believe it is positive. Like, I haven't really heard a whole lot of overwhelmingly negative things about it myself. But then again, because I haven't read it, I don't really want to hear people's discussions about it. But what if people didn't like that sequel? What if people are like, it's just so inferior to the other two sequels, and it's just the first three in general? Well, what then? It's like, yeah, basically you decided, oh, I'm going to we're disregarding these now. We're going to redo a whole series, and based off the fourth book. And really, the way they were talking about it, you don't really understand or know how. Because they kind of made it like it will be connected to the Girl with a Dragon Tattoo 2011 American version, yet different. But they were not at all going to really address what happened in 2 and 3, which you really need to do. 2 and 3, a lot of stuff has happened. Within that, ignoring those two books, those two potentially and much needed movies for this franchise is a big mistake. Because, you know, it'd be like a 2.5 hour film like Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. I'm assuming that the girl in the spider's web, or I don't know. Yeah, the girl in the spider's web. Yeah, okay. Yeah. You'd have to have, like, the first 5-10 minutes to condense the entire story of what happened in 2 and 3, because you're not going to make 2 and 3. They basically made it, we're going forward, we're not going to go back and do those. The only thing that will be acknowledged, it seemed like, was the first one. But even then, it was kind of really wonky in that. So even if they were going to completely reboot the entire thing with the fourth book, and they were going to ignore the first one, which I've read different things, so I'm kind of jumping back and forth, but still, there's like all this stuff going on that I'm like, are you acknowledging the first one, or are you completely ignoring it? Like, this didn't happen. Because you'd have to address then the first one, if not acknowledging it at all. Because then now you'll have to have what happened in 1, 2, and 3, as opposed to 2 and 3. Which would be a lot more stuff you have to condense in a short amount of time. That way, your movie can go and be its own thing. Because there will be so much information gone if they rebooted it like that. And, you know, it's finally happening. But now Rooney Mara isn't even going to be in the film. Which is weird, because at first when they announced they are finally making the movie, she was in it. Without a doubt, the director, who I don't know who this guy is, really, hold on. What did this guy make? Oh. Okay, well. Oh, don't breathe. Okay, that's what the guy made. Now they have an article about it. I'll put in the description for you to read. But basically, they're. At first, she was going to, but the article now is saying that she isn't. It's an entire new cast. That's the fun of it, is they're gonna cast a new Elizabeth. Meanwhile, the studio, because it's the same studio, they have the rights to it, and they're gonna make it. They're, I guess, gonna buy out her contract. Or if they're not, they're just ignoring it completely, and then just essentially just giving Rooney Mara the shaft. Now, I know for Daniel Craig, he's always been a little up in the air whether he would do it or not with the rumors of money and stuff. Again, don't know if that's true, but I'm sure, you know, if you gave him the scripts and they were really great, I'm sure he would agree to it. And particularly if you get most of the cast and crew back together, he'd be probably, I'm sure, on board. Because in interviews of his, he seemed like he had a good time making it, and he liked the experience. But then again, maybe that for him, it's like he liked the people he worked with, but it's like it might be like a one-time thing, you know. Had that great experience, you don't want to chance it by doing a sequel, and then that experience, the fun experience you had the first time, and you think it'll be even greater, is not, and it's just completely, yeah, that could be. But I'm sure if the script was good, and also if they negotiated pay, because if that was an actual problem, maybe you could get some sort of profits from the back end. You know, yeah, they might give him some money up front, but he'll be well compensated for back ends like ticket sales, Blu-ray DVD sales, rentals, so on. If they negotiate that with him, I'm sure, you know, and on top of a good script, I'm sure he'd be fine and happy. Rooney Mara really wanted to do it though. Out of everybody, she was the one who always wanted it. I remember she said that she still signed for it. She still signed for the sequels, and she's gonna do them because no one has said to her, "Nope, you're not doing it." But and then she jokingly would say, like, "But even if they said that, I probably would still do it." It just goes to show how much she likes the character, how much she still likes the character. I mean, you have at least one person who was and is still truly enthused with the character and the material and everything about the girl with the dragon tattoo, the sequels, the franchise, that world, and the character itself. And yet, nope, we're gonna recast her. I could see Daniel Craig maybe letting him go, but I mean, the chemistry that she and Daniel Craig had was very good. It was really good. You like believed it. I did, at least. But it would just be if it turns out she isn't it and he isn't, it'll be different. And maybe not even a good different. It might be just really weird and awkward, and it's just. Because yeah, it's like it'll be a sequel, but it's the fourth book. That's what they're going for now, and I'm like, quit rebooting everything. And I know they say it's a sequel, not a reboot, but still, there's not a lot of information on it, and they're just like, just do a sequel. Do the second book and then the third. don't do the fourth book unless after it's all said and done, and you're done with the third, and then you have people saying, like, if you have people like, I'd like to continue this, like, it's sad we have to stop now. And if you, all of you feel like doing one more wouldn't hurt, then fine. But if you, then do the fourth one. But if you all think that, after the third one, after the girl kicks the hornet's nest, if you think that's, you know, not good, or if you think it's not good to keep going with the series, then okay, fine. But don't just reboot the series while trying to say it's a sequel, because, well, it would be a sequel, technically. You were omitting so much material from 2 and 3, unless you're gonna really cram it in, and if they do that, it's not gonna be really good, personally. I don't think so. And I think they'll have to reboot it if this is the way they're actually going. It's just so stupid that they keep rebooting all these franchises. And you know what? If you reboot this, who's to say this movie will even be somewhere as close to being as good or as profitable without all the original cast members, at least, since David Fincher, you know, he didn't have a contract to do the other two film adaptations of the other two books. Nor did Daniel Craig have a contract to do the two more films, but still, you know. You know, negotiating. It's a film studio. Negotiate. The film industry itself is really, it gets pretty dumb at times. And I feel this is one of those moments when it's dumb. I could go on and on more, but I don't think I should. I will say one more thing, though. Particularly regarding Rooney Mara. She got an Academy Award nomination for The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. Yes, she lost, and I understand awards and nominations and the whole grand, and the whole big picture, really. It doesn't mean anything at all. And yet, she was really an unknown. In that, before that film, how many people heard of Rooney Mara? And this isn't an insult to her. She's a great actress. She's one of my favorite actresses, particularly around now. But she was in the Nightmare on Elm Street remake. And she was in The Social Network. And that last part, The Social Network, she was only in there not that long. She's not in there a whole lot. It's like this is the beginning, and you never see her again, really. Yeah, she was the main character in A Nightmare on Elm Street, but a lot of people aren't fans of that movie. For a lot of reasons, you know, first of being sacrilege of remaking a horror classic, and personally, I thought the acting in that film was very good, but the, I don't know, the execution was meh. I got what they're trying to do, but I don't know, it didn't work all that great for me. I mean, she was great. Jackie Earl Haley as Freddy Krueger was great, but that film It's not that great, but still, okay, made money. But these two big things before the girl with the dragon tattoo, and she did, like, independent films, I believe, yeah, before. So really, the girl with the dragon tattoo is the film that made her, or at least put her where she is now, essentially. I think that would be fair to say. And then her getting an Oscar nomination for that role, clearly that means she did a great job, or at least a good enough job to be considered to be somebody worthy of the, like, a best kind of award, or at least that's what it's supposed to be, you know, the best award for film business, where if you do such a great job, you can get nominated and possibly win, and you will be an Academy Award winner. But if you're not, you're an Oscar or Academy Award nominee, which she is, twice nominated, but, you know, that was her first, and that was the first major movie people really ever, people took notice of her. And the fact of how enthusiastic she is about that film and the character and the series, and how much she was so looking forward to the sequels, now it looks like she's not even going to get that chance to do anymore. She's not going to be able to possibly recapture that magic and get in that character again. And it's actually kind of sad when you see an actress like her who liked that character, liked that role, likes the material so much, and she had a contract to do two more, and now she's not even going to get that chance. Again, maybe things will work out. I believe it was just announced not that long ago, maybe like today or yesterday or whatever. But, I mean, it's really just been announced as of now. Maybe we'll get more news about what happens later, but as of now, it's just really disappointing to fans of the series, and particularly the fans of the first one, the American one, that were looking forward to more. I hope they get Rooney Mara back. I hope they're able to get Daniel Craig and Robin Wright and the other actors and actresses that would be in the sequels before they even attempt to try to make the fourth one. Do the girl who played with fire and the girl who kicked the hornet's nest. And then if everybody involved thinks that they would like to make at least one more, and, you know, the people involved, like, you know, Daniel Craig, Rooney Mara, all of them, because I don't believe David Fincher will get involved at this point. Maybe he will, but I doubt it. I hope this director will be able to get the cast back and the crew. Consistency is what we need. Don't end up being like Batman, the 90s Batman, because you had Michael Keaton, and then after two movies, he left because he wasn't a huge fan of where the series was going with Batman Forever. And Val Kilmer came in, and that was meh at best. You know, he wasn't awful, but he just wasn't anything special. Then you had Batman Robin, and the less said about that fiasco is better. George Clooney was... So please, get the cast and crew back. Even if Fincher won't come back, which it looks like he won't, please, director of this film, I'm sorry for not pronouncing your name, but I would just butcher it awful. I would awfully butcher your name, and I can't even talk right now anyway, so on top of that, it just would be awful of me trying to attempt to say your name. But if you ever see this, which I doubt, but who knows, get Rooney Mara. Get her as Elizabeth. Talk to Daniel Craig. And then, you know, you in the studio and him can talk stuff out and hammer out a good deal. You know, maybe give him a little bit of money up front. And then give him some back end. I don't know. You know, back end profits, ticket sales and whatnot. Should keep him happy on the financial front. And as long as the script's good, you know, I'm sure he would be even more enthused, really. I would be if I was part of part of a franchise that took so long after the first one to ever have a sequel. You know, I might have reservations about coming back. But if the script was right, and then, you know, how, and if I'm getting a good deal on the money end, that would just be like icing on top of the cake already. You know, it's already great and as perfect as can be, but now, like, the payday will, I would be handsomely rewarded after it's all said and done. Do a continuation of the first one. We'll call that Millennium 1. Do Millennium 2 and 3. The girl who played with fire and the girl who kicked the hornet's nest. And I know I keep repeating this, but really I just am tired of reboots. And I believe a whole bunch of other people are too. And I was just somebody on my phone and I'm sure they're gonna agree. Some reboots are fine, but those who saw The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, the American version, people liked it. So it wasn't the big, huge blockbuster you were hoping for. It didn't fail at the box office. It made the budget back. If I recall correctly, I believe it did, yeah. Maybe you need to market the film better. The next films, market them better. That way, people will see it and be more intrigued. And also make it a note of people knowing this is a follow-up to The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, because otherwise you might lose some people that would go and see the film. Well, I'm about 40 minutes now, and I really tried to condense this as much as possible, but hey, at least it wasn't an hour long. But that's all I've got to say about it. I hope Rooney Mara and Daniel Craig come back. And, yeah. A link to the articles below. See you next time.